Hello everyone, I hope that you are doing well. In the last videos, we learned how to create bash script files. We learned how to enter our commands such as ls, pwd or any commands that normally we write them on the Linux terminal. We learned how to print out strings, text by using echo or printf. Then we learned how to get some inputs by using read command. Now what if we want to compare these values that we get, or some other values? We want to see which numbers are greater, or I don't know, the numbers are equal or not. I mean any conditions, checking any conditions. For having this kind of commands in the bash script or any kind of programming language, we use if statements. If statement is used for comparing and having some conditions. For example, if this condition is correct, do this. If it is not correct, do another activity. When we want to compare two numbers by using if, or we want to include any condition in if, we write if, then we open a square bracket. Here we want to compare two variables that are numbers. So as you remember from the previous video, we use dollar sign, then we put the number of the variable that we want to compare with another one. So the first condition is that we want to see that the number, the first number, is greater than the second one or not. In bash script, for this we write dash, then we write greater than, GT. Again, the dollar sign and the second variable. Don't forget to put space before and after the square brackets. After that, we will write then. It means that, okay, if the first variable is bigger than the second one, so we can do anything that we want. For example, we are going to write the first number is greater. This is the first condition. What if we want to see that they are equal or not? In this case, for having another condition, we use elif. Elif means, okay, the first condition, which is number one is greater than number two, is not correct, so check this one. And here again we are going to include our condition. We are going to say that the first variable is equal by using dash, okay, equal the second variable. So in this case, again, we can do anything we want. For example, we can write the numbers are equal. Okay, so the first condition, this one, is checking that num1 is greater than num2 or not. If it is correct, it is going to execute this line. So if it is not correct, number one is not greater than number two, it is going to go to the second one, which is the next else if, and over there it is going to see that num1 is equal to num2 or not. And what if the conditions, both conditions, are not correct? So num2 is greater than num1. In this case we write else. It means that all other conditions before this is not correct here. So the first one is not greater than the second one and they are not equal, so what is the result? Num2, the second number, is greater. And don't forget to close if when it is finished. So if is for the starting, for initiating the if command, fi for finishing, and the conditions are put inside the square brackets, and the commands that or the things that we want to execute are put after then. So let's check our program. Just we should command these lines because we don't need them anymore. Okay, so let's run the program. Okay, please enter the first number. I'm going to enter 5. Please enter the second number. I'm going to enter 2. So the first number is greater. Let's check for 2 equal numbers. The numbers are equal. Okay, so far so good. And let's check for the third condition. So the second is greater. We can write the second number or anything. Okay, we have written the second is greater, so it is executing the second condition. So in a nutshell, until here about if command, it is for comparing and for having some conditions. For example, in this program we have 2 numbers, we get them from the input, then we compare them, and based on the result we execute any commands that we want.